Tampa right now has a little bit of rain coming in from the coast. Our sea breeze is trying to work in. We do see just isolated showers, no thunderstorms. And by late day, we may have a couple of rumbles. But right now, just some downpours rolling out of the Scottsmore area shortly. There's Lake Harney. So right up 95, some wet roads. Sam Sula, just a couple of showers in the vicinity in between there and Osteen, Lake Helen. Right around Deltona, you may see one or two of those just breeze by. Flagler Beach should be dry, Daytona Beach as well. But see just a few spotty showers over the Atlantic that I'll keep an eye on in case they do try to brush the coast. Temperatures, though, are definitely running hot. We have upper 80s and low 90s from the beaches back inland right now, 91 at OIA. We talked about the humidity, the heat index, 98 in Orlando, 97 at Daytona Beach, and afternoon highs right around 94 in town, 95 Leesburg, 91 for Titusville. So all these readings just slightly above average high pressure, really trying to build in over the next couple of days and heat us up. In fact, we see this steady onshore east-southeast wind. So that means one or two coastal showers, mainly for the first half of the day, and then we transition that rain chance inland fairly quickly. So for tonight, for tomorrow, we'll see that same pattern. Not much change to that yet. 5 o'clock this afternoon, I-4 to the north and west is where we'll have our best chance to see an isolated downpour or lightning storm. Through 8 o'clock, I-75 will continue to see a chance of a storm. And then in the morning, we could wake up again with one or two of those little coastal showers, mainly Brevard. Look at the rain chances for tomorrow into Tuesday afternoon. Even lower. Let's go ahead and fast forward to Wednesday. Not much rain out there, guys. So it's hot in July, and we need the rain to cool us off. Brown lawns are going to be the thing. Let's go ahead and track the tropics. We have in number 97L. This is a tropical wave, another tropical wave in the Caribbean. They're both moving to the west, and neither one of them is going to develop very quickly. Our Bermuda High determines our storm track, and as you can see, we have a couple of possibilities. There's the storm track that you get up the eastern seaboard. We've had storms that have been moving more west than north this season because our high is just east of Bermuda. So our storm track right now continues to be to the south of Florida. And you see our computer model forecast for that particular investigation area, number 97. Climatologically speaking, you might see it track up the Florida East Coast. But with our pattern that we have now, all the models are focused again on the western Gulf as this moves toward the west at about 15 miles an hour. Not going to be a threat for us, but we'll continue to watch it over the next couple of days. Meantime, your evening plans, just watching out for those stray storms through about 5, 6 o'clock, and then all that transitions to the west. Low rain chances, that's the big story. Mid-90s, the other big story. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Jason.